Hey guys, and welcome back to Serious Sam Classics Revolution. We are in the Moon Mountains on I Am Ugh-Zan difficulty, and we will be killing 380 enemies today. And in the process of doing so, we're going to be quick saving a lot, because this level is actually really, really hard if you don't know exactly what you're doing. There's two purple dudes there, they're pretty cool, but I'm going to shoot one of them with a rocket, and just going to shoot in that direction from that point on, because if you kill either one of those two purple guys, then that green dude will spawn. I guess I accidentally shot the floor in front of him or something, I'm not sure, but either way, killing one of those two guys spawns him, and you want to be careful with killing him because he can deal damage, and that's bad. If you walk over this bridge, then it explodes, and you have to live on this island from that point on. And we will be taking this level very much on an island-by-island basis, because it is very, very easy to die on near enough any of these islands. These first two are not too bad. But as you can see from these clear skeletons that are just jumping off, they sort of explode and then fly into the air for some reason. If we do that, the same happens. So preferably, we want to try and stay on these islands. We will be luring the enemies to fall off the level as much as possible. But there will be a point where doing that will actually cause them to be near enough unkillable. Also, I accidentally killed too many of the purple people and spawned these dudes. If you kill... Alright, that looks a bit normal. If you don't, kill the purple dudes, those guys won't actually spawn, which is delightful and something you should keep in mind. And you can tell from the blood that they died when it just flies in the air, but this first island's not too bad. This first island's one of the easier ones for sure, and as long as these guys are not made of fire, then we can just ignore them pretty much and just take them down one by one after the fact, because they are just too bad at existing. If any of these are ice, you probably want to take care of them immediately, because they can run into you and make life a lot harder for you if you don't immediately kill that red biomechanoid. I will be quick saving at the end of every island, because it's just so easy to fall off and die or something stupid like that, so I'm going to be real careful. Now the first bridge, if you don't walk far enough, you can actually trigger the battles, but the bridge won't explode, so you can sort of stay at the start there. This bridge will never explode. Not sure why, but it doesn't. It doesn't even make an explosion sound. There are actually other bridges which don't explode as well. Well, one, actually. And it even makes the exploding noise, but it just doesn't explode for some reason. Not really sure why, but we will be taking that to our advantage, because there's a lot of stuff here. A lot of green musilisks. Reptiloids, not musilisks. That's a different game. And they are in really awkward positions. One's all the way over there, one is all the way over there, and they blend in quite nicely with the rest of the terrain, as you can probably see, since everything is green and they are as well, but taking care of them, not too much of an issue if you know exactly where they are. I love that. I don't know why that happens as well, because it doesn't happen with the, biomechanoids that they're, gibs just fly up in the air, but for some reason, with those guys, it does. I don't know why. I accept it in my life. I'm perfectly okay with that. But yeah, second island, definitely not too hard because this bridge stays alive forever. And genuinely not sure why. I guess it's just a broken trigger, or it just is supposed to not explode. With this one, it doesn't really make sense. With that one, at the end, it kind of does for a reason, but we'll get into that. But moving on, gonna quick save here. And now we're gonna do island 3. And I'm hoping I can edit that into something comprehensible if I die here. Because when that bridge explodes, you get some skeletons, and if you accidentally get pushed too far, then you get pushed off and you die. And there's only one kamikaze for some reason, which is nice. So once you take care of that guy, all that's left is the rather large quantity of clear skeletons that you have to deal with. But since a lot of them just fall off, it's not too much of a hassle. Plus, if you know how to deal with clear skeletons at this point, then you should be entirely okay. But I'm not exactly doing it in the safest way right now, but as long as you sort of get all of them to be in the same location and in the same rhythm, then they will just never hit you, which is lovely. And before you know, we're already done. Look at that. Didn't even need the quick save, which is genuinely surprising because there's so many instances where you try this and then two of them just accidentally hit you and you just get pushed off and you die. And that's that then. So be careful of that for sure. This is the island of death, and I'm going to quick save again, because I'm scared. And with this particular island, you can actually get away with walking on this area for a while, and we're not actually going to spawn the next row of enemies just yet. We're actually going to pick up this first, because there is an armor over there and I want it, and picking up that bullet power up makes it fling into the air all the way over there, and that's lovely. So there's a tiny hill over here, It's kind of hard to see, but it's definitely there. If we're walking sort of in that direction and around at this point start shooting like this, we should hit that guy immediately and he won't be able to shoot at us. And then the rest of these guys, we're sort of hoping that the NARS are not on fire, and we're also going to be moving in a like fairly specific pattern over this area over here, because there's a lot of harpies that are going to be spawning here and I don't want to deal with them. And I want to make sure that I don't accidentally catch fire. There's a bunch of them that are still spawning over there as well, and I want them to like bunch up as much as possible. And the way to do that is to just stick to the edge of this island. So you kind of need to know what this island looks like while you're walking around, because you're going to be walking backwards most of the time. But it is so easy to get super overwhelmed here. It is one of the easiest places for sure in this entire level to die. I really struggled with this area at first when I just didn't really have a plan for it, because I just got destroyed. I just didn't know what I was supposed to do. It genuinely took me quite a while to figure this out. But if you just stick to the edges of the island, you should be a-okay because of how these guys spawn. You need to make sure that after a while they just don't spawn anymore. At that point, you just take them out with rockets. But you also need to be sort of aware that this level has a lot of rockets and a lot of Tommy gun ammo. So if you just keep that in mind and just use that as much as possible when you can, then killing these dudes isn't that big of a deal once you've got them sort of in a pattern where they just use their range attack on you at all times. But it is so easy to die here, like absolutely. If one of these harpies is on fire and you're just unlucky, then you just burn to death. If you like mess up moving, then you just get overwhelmed by harpies that are spawning there and you're just like here or something and you don't know. Just, like there's so many ways to die. And I'm glad I got that over with, and I'm gonna quick save immediately again, because the next island is also just, there's a lot of room for death, and I'm scared every single day of my life. Now, another bridge gets destroyed, and there is another large batch of enemies. This time, it is marsh hoppers, clear skeletons, and the blue robot people. The blue robot people, not that much of an issue, as you can see. There's also some NARS, but that's also not too much of a hassle either. But there's going to be a green reptiloid. Why am I calling them mutalisk every time? It's a completely different enemy from a completely different game. But either way, there's one right over there that's trying to kill you. And the clear skeleton is actually icy, which is becoming an increasingly large problem right now. Maybe it's one of the other enemies, but this clear skeleton is like seriously slowing me down, and it's quite an issue. But killing that guy, replace it with one that isn't, and that guy is dead. There is still some icy enemies, apparently, because we did just slow down a bit, but damage honestly doesn't really matter as long as you survive. And the next island isn't that bad either, which is nice. But this is all going surprisingly well. I've not died yet. And like every practice run so far, I've already died like 4 times at this point. So I'm actually genuinely quite surprised by how well this is going. Now this is the second bridge, which does not get destroyed. It does play the explosion noise, but it doesn't explode, which is nice. And we will again be using that to our advantage, because there is going to be a large quantity of dudes that I don't want to take care of at the same time. So shoot some more rocks in that direction. I hope I'm hitting them. And I think I am, yeah. And there's going to be some clear skeletons that are going to have trouble actually reaching me. And another one, which is just dandy. Do be careful of like their range attacks as well, because it's very easy to die to them. Also be careful of rockets, because rockets, you know, just the general ideas of try to stay alive because things hurt. But all in all, I think we should be okay as long as we don't shoot a rocket in our own face, which is very possible with these things, by the way. Like those green balls do like destroy your rockets as well when you hit them, and that's bad. Like that's not exactly something you want to deal with right in front of your face. And I am glad that everything is just going so swimmingly right now. There is still one dude alive over here, which we're going to take care of by shooting a rocket in our own face, like I mentioned before. And we're going to go back over the bridge. This is actually like a bridge where I can sort of see why it doesn't explode. But it does play the explosion sound, but I don't know. But if this bridge did explode, then you'd probably have to rocket jump back to this area if you want to get all kills and all secrets. Because there's a secret area over here. And I'm actually going to quick save before this jump as well, because I've failed this jump so many, many times. It's actually easier to do this with a rocket jump, but let's see how it goes. Nyeh. Alright, we did it. Cool. So that jump, I'm going to actually immediately quick save again. It's very easy to fail, but if you just like try to jump to this edge, it's not too bad. I think in the HD remake, it's actually a lot easier, but it's fine. It's all good. That's just great. You don't really want that guy that spawns to the right of you to really have any like modification, but you can't really control that, unfortunately. But if that one's on fire, then everything's just pain, and it's not a life you want to lead. But there is still a large quantity of enemies alive here. But first, we're gonna go over here because there is a health power-up right here. And I'm gonna pick it up immediately because I tend to forget it exists and then it's a secret area, so I gotta get it. Then I'm gonna quick save here again because this is another area where everything can go horrible. Because if you jump sort of over here, over that thing, then over here, a dude will spawn. There's actually a clear skeleton to my left right now as well, but I'm actually gonna jump over this and wait for a bit. And the reason why I'm waiting here is something you can hear right now. As you can hear, there is an insane amount of clear skeletons to my left. And I don't want to deal with any of them right now. So instead, we're going to deal with this red dude that spawned just a second ago by just shooting him with some rockets, like five or something. Or five, and then we switch to the Tommy gun and we shoot his right turret. Because if you shoot his right turret, then the rocket will get destroyed immediately because you can shoot their rockets out of the air. And that way, he can't actually damage you, which is lovely. I'm just gonna wait for a little bit longer. There's still a clear skeleton over there, and there is also a invisible gnar here, so I'm just gonna take care of that. But there should be, like, one over here, yeah. Which isn't too bad, but you want to make sure that everything is very dead before you get started on this. Because, as you probably could already hear, there's a lot of them. But if you just jump back there, then they sort of all just gather up over there, and you want to make use of those situations, because again, we have a lot of rockets at our disposal in this level. Even though we're only at 44 right now, we're gonna get a lot back, so you might as well. And it just makes this a lot easier, because otherwise you have to deal with that red biomechanoid, that clear skeleton, that gnar, and then a bunch of these dudes over here as well, and it's just very overwhelming. I don't like it, so we're not gonna do that. But first we're gonna walk in this direction again. There are some rockets over here, but we will be shooting them a bunch as well, because there's a bunch of fiery gnars that might spawn here. Nearly hit myself in the face with a rocket there, so that was good. It's actually random whether or not these are on fire, like all of them, I think, but it's still something you probably just want to shoot with rockets in case the ones behind you have, like, fire as well. Just because these guys are pretty good at touching you usually, so be a little careful. These guys are also very invisible. Like, compared to the average invisibility of this game, those guys are very hard to see. So, yeah, very careful times, because otherwise you die. And there are quite a lot of them. Now, there is one unusual enemy next to these guys, I guess, but these guys are not that unusual. And that is a kamikaze, which is over there. And we're actually going to lure it back a bit, because this one has a special property, even though it's not immediately visible. And that special property is that he has a spawn point attached to him that just spawns these guys wherever he dies, which is unusual. I don't think I've seen that before, but it also spawns a bunch of enemies over there, which is why I actually lured him all the way back over here, because then we can take care of these two groups one at a time, and it just makes the quantity, the sheer quantity of frogs that you have to deal with a little bit lower. The one that just jumped just hit me, so he's dead now, so that's nice, because these guys do die the moment they attack once, which is why they're in such large numbers. Which I think I've already said like 14 times at this point, but I like repeating myself incessantly. Now, next hard part. It just keeps coming. We will be picking up all these things because there will be a wall behind us in a second, so we won't be able to really go back there, I do believe. We're going to shoot that guy, that guy, that guy, and this last purple dude will spawn a Blumen, which is over there, which we'll be shooting with rockets. And the reason we're using rockets is also because there's one over there. This is a problem. Kind of hoping that you will cooperate a little bit better. And there is a one armor power-up over here, which I don't want to pick up. I think it's just that one, which spawns a thing. And we will be circling around this place for a while, just going to be picking up all the rocket power-ups because we can. There are some purple dudes still down there somewhere, but I always forget where they are, and they're kind of irrelevant anyway. But we will just be circling this rather large circle for a while because it's just the easiest way to take care of all these harpies over here. Just keep running right, basically. Running left seems to be worse than walking right in this place for some reason, at least in my experience. But maybe I just did it wrong because I practiced running right more. I don't know, but either way, this works. The reason I'm not picking up that one armor power-up is because it spawns a red biomechanoid rather close to you. And I kind of want these guys to be dead before I get started on that nonsense. So I'm just going to focus on that for a while. Going to try to stay close to the one armor power-up so I don't have to walk back too far, but that's mostly just laziness speaking. And we're going to grab that because that is going to be fun. Going to be shooting the right turret again and missed the rocket entirely, so I'm happy about that. This one, I'm not really 100% sure what the best course of action is. I think I just shot one of his rockets in midair, with my rocket, so good stuff, I guess. But yeah, just try to run away as quickly as possible and you'll probably be okay, honestly. Quick save, because more nonsense. There's two purple dudes still here, I believe. There should be. I think there's two usually. I don't know. Maybe I'm imagining things. Either way, yeah, there he is. I don't know what was taking him so long. This hole is a special hole. Yeah, because enemies that fall down this hole don't die. And I'm not sure why, because if I fall down this hole, I do die. And that means that if one falls down, you can technically still shoot it by just shooting down there, but it's just really horrible. And I don't want to do it. And naturally, the two enemies we're fighting here are both bulls, who are actually very, very good at jumping off of this area, which is great. It is just perfect. And we're actually going to be dealing with that hole a little bit later as well. So we will just be taking care of that. No. because it is possible to shoot them while they're falling down as well, but it's like you have to do it with the Tommy gun and kind of hope that you hit them. And after a while, their position is awful because, like, the area down there is also not solid, so they will just be walking through the wall, and then it's pretty much impossible to see them at that point. There's just a lot of horribleness to that particular area, and if you're trying to kill all enemies, it's one of the more irritating spots for sure. Now, this one armor power-up, of course it's evil, because why wouldn't it be? Two reptiloids, which get shot by his friend, which is good, and also a red biomechanoid who helped us kill that green reptiloid, so I guess I should be a little bit grateful, though. Still not a huge fan of these guys, I'm going to be honest. Not my best friends. But either way, they're completely optional. If you don't pick up that armor shard, then they don't spawn, so it's not exactly something you really need to worry about, but... you know, if you're trying to pick up things, it's kind of nice to know about, I guess. So, kamikaze, and quick save, and I'm going to have a little coughing fit for now, so I hope to see you in a sec. Alright, good. Now, we didn't jump down this hole just yet, but we will be going into this door, because there is one. And there are many things behind this wall. One of which is a door that closes behind us, which is excellent. But there is also this thing, and we will be shooting rockets in that direction. The Reptiloids actually seem weaker on this difficulty than on any other difficulty for some reason, but I'm not really sure why that is. Might just be my imagination, honestly, but I think you need more rockets on any other difficulty than this one, and then that's unusual, seeing as this is the difficulty where everyone else has more health than usual. I don't know. But either way, shooting them with rockets usually works fairly well. You need to be a little bit careful of the balls afterwards, obviously, but... because they do hurt a lot. And as you can see, I'm alive. Excellent. I only have 30 health, but we can pick this up now. But yeah, not really sure what that's all about, why they're weaker on this difficulty. Maybe they just figured it would be a nice balance to actually make this, like, viable at all, because otherwise you'd just run out of ammo compared to the rest of the world. But I don't know. Either way, we're jumping down here, and there is a bunch of harpies down here. You kind of want to be holding the jump button as you fall down here. Also, I didn't really want to land on that health power-up because it spawns a bunch of fish. And we have to deal with harpies first rather than this, but I guess this is the life we lead. They do all spawn in the exact same spot, so if you just aim in that location, you can just keep shooting and they all die, but... it's a little bit fiddly. It's kind of hard to see the harpies like this, so you kind of want to just bob up and just shoot them, but... while you're up here, they can use their melee attacks. If you're underwater, they will not use their melee attack against you, because I guess these guys can just not be underwater for some reason. And I'm really not sure why, but I believe they just stop moving entirely when you go underwater. But they will keep shooting at you, and your movement is a little bit slower in the water, so... it is actually quite easy to get hit by their ranged attacks here, unless you don't, like, if you don't move horizontally away from them, then often they will still hit you, which is scary. But that went okay. I'm not really worried about my health. There are a lot of fish in these waters, but overall, there's a lot of free stuff that you can get. Like, this armor over here is entirely free. No fish will spawn when I pick this up. And there's another health bar up over there, which we'll be grabbing in just a second. But first, just looking around. Actually, I might as well just... I think I can just grab it now. I'm actually not sure. I'm just going to pick up everything else first. But here's some rockets. I believe they do spawn. No one. All right. You can tell that I really know what I'm doing here. This one will definitely spawn fish. Oh, it's that armor and rockets and ammo that spawns it, I guess. But yeah, that one spawns a reasonably large number of fish immediately. Like, a lot of the fish spawn one by one, but these ones are just all there instantly, so... keep your tummy gun in hand, because it's pretty much just the best weapon against them, because it stuns them, and you can take a lot of them down very quickly. This one should spawn some more fish. They do spawn rather erratically compared to the other one. Like, the other one really only had one spawner. And these all spawn in, like, one of three areas, I think, which is why you can't just hold down the mouse in a singular location, which I actually kind of appreciate because it makes it a little bit more complicated. And I do like myself some complicated puzzles when it comes to shooty games. But before we move on in that direction, we are going to be jumping up here, grab ourselves some more health, some super secret serious health that we have found, and we will be moving on to the final area of this level, which again has some nasty things in it. Not so much when trying to stay alive. If you're just trying to complete the level, this area is actually not that bad. But if you're trying to kill all enemies, there's more nonsense, which is like, oh, an enemy fell down a hole and now it's pretty much impossible to kill it. And it's just sad. There's a weird thing there. It lowers when you start fighting the dudes. We're gonna shoot it now because it spawns some secret stuff. It spawns some secret ammo and things. And it also spawns this teleporter, which as long as you're close enough to it, it will like count as a secret area. And that teleport will teleport you to the other side of this room, which will actually skip a rather difficult battle over here, which is lovely. I'm gonna quick save here because this is, this is basically where nonsense comes into play for realsies, because my strategy for this is to line up this pylon pole thing with the one over there, I believe, or is it like this? I actually don't fully remember. Oh no, wait, it's like this, I think. And then I have to shoot in that direction because there's a green dude that spawns over there, as you can see, and I actually missed him immediately. And please die, please die, please die. Okay, he's dead. So that guy is the main problem of this room when trying to kill all enemies. And the reason for that is that he walks forward and then just falls down. And again, this is still part of that area with the hole where an enemy that falls down here doesn't actually die. And that's a considerably larger problem than it sounds. Because he doesn't actually attack you anymore either, but he's just like pretty much impossible to kill at that point because he's just in such an awkward location. Now, I did miss a couple of rockets, which actually makes me really sad because if you time it right, like if you shoot those rockets immediately, then you can fight these guys pretty much the moment the other like three dudes die. And it just works out really well. But if you move around just fairly accurately over here, then usually these guys won't actually be able to hit you at all, but you need to know how to move around here, otherwise again you just get destroyed and swarmed. And again, you can also actually just grab the teleporter over there, which will just teleport you to the other side of the room, and it makes life a little bit easier as well, because enemies, for the most part, enemies won't spawn in this area outside of touching just this line over here between these two poles. So as long as you sort of stick to that, then you should be entirely okay. We have 98 rockets, which is pretty good. I was kind of hoping to leave with 100, but, you know, it happens. What can you do? Not picking this up just yet, because there is a bull that spawns here. I'm actually going to quick save just in case he just decides to run off again. He spawns here if you walk in that area, but he also spawns when you pick up this armor. But if you pick up this armor, it also spawns harpies. But if you already killed him, then he doesn't spawn again, which is really quite nice, actually. And now we can just take care of these remaining harpies with our Tommy gun. Again, we can just move around in the same area if need be to kill these final enemies. And I like that because it gives us exactly enough room to move around without them using their melee attack, which is just really nice of them. It's just really nice of the game to do that for you. And that is that. Now, as you can see, that is indeed just the same like waterfall that we ran in circles around previously. But this time we can actually look through it. On the other side, it just looks like a wall, which is actually quite unusual, but that's just the way the level works. And with that, we're just going to run through this teleporter because we can and we happen to be close to it, and end the level because the end is actually right here. Now, if I didn't kill 380 enemies, I'm going to be really annoyed because I actually don't know for sure. But I did! Excellent! It always worries me because, like, if any of those enemies fall down that hole and I didn't notice it, then I pretty much just have to start the level over again because, or just load a quick save, obviously, but it's weird. I don't know why they die in the first area, but not in the second one, because it does kill you and it seems to just be the same, like, thing that causes you to die and the enemies as well, but maybe, like, it's not because they're too strong, because the red biomechanoid died as well to that same, like, death area in the first, like, set of islands, so I don't know. Either way, that is the end of this video. The next time we play, we will be doing the next level, which is Oasis, and I hope to see you guys there. I hope you enjoyed it so far, and I hope to see you guys next time. Bye-bye.